have all kinds of relationships here. So I'm just trying to figure it out. Horan and Chang Jin Huan, you guys play father and son?
Yeah, father and son.
Father and son. Okay, so tell us a bit more about your character.
Oh.
You're also his son.
Okay,
how many children you have? Big son, small son.
Younger son.
Then how come the big son is older than you?
I'm the oldest son.
So Lisa is the oldest son.
Yeah.
Okay. And then
also
the
oldest son.
Always fighting. Yeah. Oh, yeah, you got
all these. So my name is Hong Xianbei. Xianbei,
Oh really? In real life, are you a good drinker?
No.
No.
One class then
drunk.
No. He just learned. You see? How late?
Don't
the
blow.
Years and the best.
It's a hot son. Okay, so this is the oldest son, and you play the youngest son?
Yeah, I'm the second son.
Okay, but there's something unique about your character.
I cannot talk in the show, so what I'm doing is, for every sentence, it's sign language.
Wow. Yeah. So you guys have to learn a lot of sign language for the show.
Oh, no, no, for every sentence.
For me, you did a great job.
Nice.
Why?
Two weeks before the show starts.
Wow.
And after that is every week I need to meet up with the teachers for the class.
So I think you have a better appreciation for people who cannot hear, correct?
Yes.
Absolutely. Yeah. That's great. And you played the youngest son?
So most of the time in army, and I'm being mischievous, causing havoc here and there. So Harley turned out like a friend actually. So 我们其实只拍过几场戏而已嘛. Yeah, so we don't really have much chance in show, but it's a very, very interesting relationship between both of us.
Okay, and what is the relationship like?
Because he's such a unique father in the show. He just comes in like, hey guys, can I have some money? Oh, I don't drink. So my character has absolutely no respect for his character.
Oh.
Because basically,
Joel is just a troublemaker.
Oh, troublemaker.
He's going to go where he's going. So he doesn't appear in Hong Kong. He's going to be in Hong Kong. He's going to be in
Hong Kong. Alright, you're doing a good job. You said you are playing a very, you know, very naughty character, and she's like, thumbs up!
Yeah!
She likes you.
Especially
the book
in English, you know?
He's
this child's mother. What?
Tell us more about your character.
Oh, 我跟你讲，在现实的生活里面呢，我是爸爸的爸爸，所以我祝普天下的父母们，妈妈节已经过了哈，现在是父亲节哈，所以祝双亲都健康，好不好？ 然后我今天呢，我在不平凡里面的平凡，不是很平凡的一个人，因为到现在我才出来一下子一点点而已，啊，就好像人家吃东西吃的中毒一样啊，闹上了不讲点博物馆，啊，所以你们看我的戏要小心看一点啊，不要去厕所啊，不然的话就看不到我。但是我的啊，
等一下，我觉得陈大哥，
我觉得陈大哥谦虚了，
他说他只是一点点，不一点，不一点，
我是说不一点哦，就要你
就很臭，不是，真的是要。戏再多再一斤，但是每一场出现，我们都是如家人的。像你的意义，像就是说我是一个老油漆，不是，真的，他说平凡的平凡，里面他是平凡的，是非常棒，因为他看外表看起来平凡，其实他的角色一点都不平凡，继续收看下去，这一个人物，这一号人物不是简单的。
Random, for those of us who don't understand,
He's playing just an ordinary character in this extraordinary show.
Yes.
But I say he's definitely not ordinary because though he looks like ordinary, but we have to keep watching because he's definitely not an ordinary guy.
Wow.
He's hiding something.
Yeah,
he's hiding something.
Nice. Thank you very much.
Okay, come here.
So Brian Wong plays his son.
Yes,
son.
Exactly.
So what is their relationship like?
Oh, very bad.
Very bad.
Yeah.
Oh, you also don't know.
Sure. Okay, keep watching. Stay tuned. Stay tuned.
7:30 PM. Okay. Ying Ying, tell us more about your character.
Hello everyone, I'm Ying Ying. 大家好，我是文莹。然后在里面呢。
等一下，静初，我觉得尖叫声不够大声，只是说莹莹他们就要尖叫了吗？你再讲一次。Hi
everyone, my name is
何莹莹。哇，干嘛讲话嘛，对不对？OK，好。非常
Mix Star Awards. So yes, tell us about your character.
Yeah, so 静初 is a rich girl, but she's a spoiled. She's romantically involved with Zheng Huan. Oh. And since he can't speak,
the entire scene,
he's not talking at all. So he's just signing, and I have to. So the whole scene is just me talking.
So it's the ideal boyfriend, and he doesn't talk.
Yeah. So he can't.
The other way around. He can't. Doesn't talk.
This boyfriend cannot nag on you or buying anything.
For a night, huh? So I think most men would like the girl to not be speaking so much. It's okay. So how did you guys meet in the show? Can you tell?
It's actually a very strange way that we met. I went to the mini mart to buy some stuff. Uh-huh. The mini mart which their family runs.
Okay.
And he was the cashier. Then he fell in love with me at first sight. And
of course. Who wouldn't fall in love with me at first sight? Hello. Okay.
So he stopped me, and then I thought that he was quite cute. Yeah. You know.
Wow. He's not cute. You don't like that. He left the mini mart just staring at her for 5 seconds.
Yeah,
oh my gosh, your father must have been very upset with you. Where are you? Following girls. Okay.
Yeah, so
you have a business, I don't know.
Yeah, so actually we have quite an extraordinary kind of relationship mm-hmm. that I wanted to escape from my dad's control.
Okay.
So we actually went out and basked in the streets.
Went busking?
Yeah, I sang.
Oh, sang.
And he played the ukulele.
Oh, that's so sweet.
Yeah.
Wait, do you play the ukulele in real life?
Not yet.
So you have to learn sign language and also the ukulele.
Yeah.
Who which writer doesn't like you? Make you draw these things. Too expensive.
But it's a good chance you can learn through our drama and
yes.
our character. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, let me teach you. 明年的红星大奖，他一定会拿奖的。他终于用功勋得这个东西，对不对？我也是会。 大家觉得郑桓在戏里头演得非常棒的，给他掌声鼓励一下好不好？哎，是漂亮，谢谢。
Now Brandon, you're on the show as well.
Yeah.
You forgot, right?
Tell us more about your character. Okay, 我的戏里呢就是一个另外一个麻烦制造者，可是我的麻烦呢只是制造给Brian，因为 Brian 呢跟潘玲玲是看起来是金童玉女天生一对，而我呢是从第一眼。 看到黎明呢，就一直暗恋他。我去 interview，去这个补习中心当interview当讲师的时候，我就已经爱上了潘玲玲，然后就疯狂爱上他。不管怎么样，我都要跟他在一起。所以当 Brian Wong 出现，他就会破坏我的好事。我就一直去破坏他们两个人的事情。可是现在已经播到55集，大家都看到了，他跟Brian 已经是一对了。我还没死心，我的名言就是，就算结婚了，我还可以等他们离婚。所以是一个。 很讨人厌的一个打不死的蟑螂。不是，我觉得我后来跟你一起演戏后，我才发现为什么你对玲玲会这么好。因为她从小戏里面可能就失去了父爱，她也失去了母爱，所以她到后来就发现有一个很好的奶妈，所以呢，她就看到这个奶妈又漂亮又白，所以呢。
他就爱上了他，最近我一直在看林林，因为我最近一直跟他拍戏。
你一直看林林，不是没有吗？不是，
我跟你讲，我就是他说他为什么他一直在拉衣服，他说大哥你不懂啊，现在流行这样才会刺激收视率。
哦，我说，哎呀，难怪这个LV会这么爱你，那是你的album吧？是，原来他需要的是一个奶妈。哦。Easy,
please translate what just happened here.
Basically, Oon Shu said that maybe Albert's character was lacking in mother's love.
So when you saw Ying's character,
给我们掌声鼓励一下好不好？而在现场，爸爸在这孩子和家人一起来的，你们是更棒的爸爸。对，给你们一起掌声鼓励一下。The fact that our dads are here today, right? You are all heroes here today. Thank you so much for spending time with the family, coming down here, and really making new memories. Now, happy Father's Day to all dads. And I do believe, I mean, when it comes to dads, you know, we all have our own stories, right? Yeah. So if you don't mind, you can share some stories about you and your dad, perhaps.
So, 所以现在我身为人父，我也有一个儿子，一个女儿，所以我跟他们的关系就希望可以打破那个僵局，就和我的孩子好像朋友一样，好好的相处，至少他有什么问题会告诉我，那我们有什么困难，我们也告诉我们的孩子。
Yeah, basically, his father is those traditional
traditional.
And then, so we hope the relationship between him, himself, and his son and daughter is just like friend. The younger generation, fathers like us.
Right.
So we like to be like more like friends than father and son. Mm-hmm. So that we can talk, we can play, we can share the problem, everything.
So you don't want to have that kind of serious father and child relationship with your kids? Okay.
Not serious.
You're not serious. Okay, I can tell. easy. Okay, no, we chat one more.
Yeah. 最重要，我们父子的关系是天然的，这个关系一定要就是保持的好，就是说，无论是你的观念、你的生活，总是你的生命中，你们都会有一个彼此的同在。要不然你多么好，你爱他多么多，付出多么多，结果多是一个管教，被一个教育。
是，OK， 后面大家说 ，There's no special tips in father and son relationship. As long as you know that each other, we are father and son. You have my blood in your body.
Yeah.
So you know you're my son, and then,
这关系最重要，而不是你多么去管教。
It's not how you discipline your child or how you train them to be a better child. The relationship is born by nature.
Wow.
So you know that is the most important thing in your life. So you know, whatever it is, you come back to your family.
Wow, okay, very nice. All right, so, Junhuan, a little story about you and your dad, perhaps?
Do you have a relationship
with your dad? Actually, I don't often see my dad. Actually, when he talks, he's not very often. 其实我觉得对我来说，我的父亲就是一个无论我在这里，我多长时间没有跟他见面，但我一旦遇到有困难、有挫折的时候，他总是有一个非常非常宽阔的肩膀，可以给我去依靠。是说可能我不一定真的是要这样靠着，
是，
但是他总是我的坚强的后盾。
就是遇到这不管面对什么困难，就是背后还有这个爸爸的支持，不管我成功失败，一通电话，就算没有很多的。
劝告或者是一些忠告，我觉得你爸爸听你的心声，你就很开心的，对不对？
是是是。
Basically, this is a long distance.
Long distance
relationship
in China. Yes.
So and then also, very traditional type. So they seldom talk, but whenever he has problem, he don't need to seek advice. But as long as there is a phone call, he knows that his father is with him.
That's nice. Yeah. That's great. Yeah. All right, Ying Ying. Hello, Ying Ying, everybody. So tell us your name.
掌声欢迎何盈盈。
Very good, man. I love it. I love it. I will try with my Singapore audience, but my English audience is great. I doubt it will work. Okay, Ying Ying, tell us a bit more about your relationship. Any memories from you and your dad?
Actually, my dad has been really supportive of my career choice. I mean, like, if I have 7 a.m. call time, I could ask him to drive me to work. Wow. Even if it's 7 a.m. And that is something that I'm very grateful about. I think it has something to do with the fact that he won 4D when I was born.
Wow! He will be forever in your debt.
那时候我爸爸告诉我，我出事的时候他买了狗狗还是 4D 啦，然后他肿。安慰奖励啦，可是从此以后就非常疼我。
这样你应该叫何安慰啊？
没有，
他爸爸中安慰奖吗？你叫何安慰？
他爸爸的马匹反正也都是跟我买的。
哦，
对，我是外围的。
对对对，安慰奖，安慰你而已。
So does your father still buy for you on your birthday?
I'm not sure. I never asked him, but so far he hasn't been meaning that. So
maybe he just never told you.
他很怪，他说爸爸是安慰你，不是。是你妈，你爸爸很安慰，就够了。
是是是，安慰了。
Never mind, never mind. One day just keep checking in. Dad, you buy now. Really hard to hide the winnings from me. And of course, what about you? Any stories about you?
我跟我爸爸的关系其实是我们相处的时间不多，因为在我读高中的时候，我爸爸就移民到别的国家去，他永远都不回来了。所以我是觉得深深的感受，就是说我们要重视身边的人，亲人其实亲情是很重要的。当我们现在能够有家庭的幸福的时候，我们在享天伦之乐的时候，大家好好的珍惜身边的人，不然的话等到有缺陷的时候，真的后悔补救已经来不及了。但是现在我对孩子呢就比较不像以前我爸爸那种管教的方法。以前我的爸爸是对我蛮严的，现在我跟孩子的关系是好像朋友一样，因为现在年代不一样。 OK， 好，谢谢大家，珍惜身边的人。
是的，谢谢陈大哥。我第一次听到陈大哥分享他和爸爸的关系，因为大哥在我们演艺圈当中是长辈，我们很少会去问说他跟爸爸的关系。今天是我第一次听到，我觉得哇，很惊讶。
其实我爸爸是一个很平凡的爸爸，但是在我心目中他是一个很不平凡的爸爸。他教我很多做人的道理。我今天有这样的成绩，老实讲，就是我遵循我爸爸的教导的方式去追求的。所以我在这里应该借这个机会再谢谢在天上的爸爸，谢谢他。
是，
谢
谢
陈大哥，谢谢陈大哥。就陈大哥啊，陈大哥是his father is normal dad, but to him he's an extraordinary dad, super dad.
Super dad.
He's so successful today.Because he learned from his dad.
Okay, it's good values.
Yeah, good values. Okay.
And you see.
Yes.
So you have a famous dad.
Yeah.
Ed Manchin, by the way, is the father of this young man.
You worked with him before, right?
Yes, I did. I did work with him. He's such a hilarious person.
He is. Same at home also. He never stops running around. He's super hyperactive.
Yeah.
So my mom would call him the oldest son, actually.
Oh,
the oldest son.Yeah, so you wake up early in the morning, he's like, son, let's go for breakfast, and we'll run all the way down to eat clean kopitiam or something like that. So my relationship with my dad is actually very, 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 very chill, very casual. And it's someone that is unable to express a lot to him. You know, we go to sports together, we exercise together, and we discuss work stuff also. So sometimes we work when we watch TV, we're like, hey, this character like that, and we'll just break up boundaries.
Do you have conversations with your dad where you actually emote your own feelings to each other, or are you the type that says, you know what, I love you, I show you I love you through action rather than words?
I think it's interesting because in family love, for example, dad's love, you know, pets can express love in a very one-sided way. Mm-hmm. Like, I love you this way, you take the love this way. Something can be hard for us children to accept how dads love us.
Yeah.
So for example, my dad always says, like, wake up early, let's go breakfast, and sometimes I'm extremely tired. Yeah. But I know that's his way of giving his love.
Right.
So being children ourselves, we also find a way to understand how our parents give ourselves love.
Yes.
Not just a one-sided thing. So
don't just think that they're being cruel to you or giving you this
one
only.
You
don't want to spend time with you, that is love, man.
Maybe.
我跟陈大哥一样，就是我爸爸也是已经移民了，移民到一个很远的地方了，然后我们先走了。那我曾经经历过这样的痛，就是因为我也是跟郑华一样，我们都不是原本不是新加坡人，我们从别的国家来这里打拼。然后就在我在这里工作的时候呢，我爸爸不幸过世了。
Where is your dad?
So我爸也是一样，也是严父亲。我觉得我们上一辈的爸爸都是严父亲的，可是他对孩子的爱绝对不会比我们这一代的爸爸少。只是我们这一代比较感情表达自己，会告诉孩子，哎，刚刚爹爹妈妈啊，I love you。比如说刚刚我出门的时候，我上次还一句，拜拜爹地，爹地I love you，就很棒。可是如果爸爸出去工作，我觉得我去抱爸爸，爸爸，我爱你，哇，就是，你干嘛？所以Father
didn't like to say I love you and all that.
上一代的爸爸是比较严父亲的，是他们的爱是更加内敛的。可是啊，Mr.，我们说，OK，yeah。So我觉得说，在那个时候，我爸爸过世了，我来得及赶回家去见他最后一面。所以我会在这里奉劝大家，就是不要面对一个子欲养而亲不在的一个情境，就是今天像大哥所说的，就是父母还健在的时候呢，我们多跟他们相处，多花一点时间，哪怕一个星期回父母家跟他们相聚都是很棒的。因为你不知道什么时候这个touch，他们就远离你们了。
You want to hear it, right?
Yes.
You want to hear your dad say, I love you, right? Okay. Well, that's a lesson for everybody. Fathers, children, parents, everybody wants to hear, I love you. And I know we're very Asian.
Express yourself.
You can express yourself, that'd be great, okay?
Okay, okay, so, 不然这样子好不好？我们现场来一个。现场有谁是爸爸的举手好不好？ 现场有谁是爸爸？刚刚举手。Who's the dad? Who's the dad? 没有要求。Who's the daddy? OK，然后我们做了。Who's the daddy? 可以这样的，就是哥哥，就类似这样。OK，我们现场，是爸爸的，我们表现出我们的父爱，孩子们也表现出你们对爸爸的爱，好不好？我们现场，我说三二一，我们就抱抱孩子，抱抱爸爸，说 I love you， 好不好？
So on the count of three, you say I love you. Dad, everybody says to the dad, I love you.
Okay. Two. Okay. Come.
Okay. In three.
Two.
Say it again. I'll give you extra prize.
Sometimes you're shy, right?
I got no prize, but I pretend I got the prize. Okay, very good, very good.
Cool.
I am yes. Oh, my children, my babies! So, okay guys, thank you so much. Monday to Friday, 7:30 p.m. at Channel 8. Reach for the skies, let's give it up for our cast. Reach for the skies!
We have also other Channel 5 Twitter blog artists coming up on stage as well. 走了。 Alright, bye.
Hello.
Hey, Drama King is back again.
Good one, good one. Good one. Good
one. Good one.
Good one. Good one. Good one. Good one.
Good one. Good很多人跟呢，很多人跟呢，
没有机会就算了，还有机会也跟他加入，有机会也跟你加入，那你干嘛？你去干嘛？
哇，这个这样远的，走不动了。有车啊！
对，拍合车牌，
九四零零啊
，OK on 啊，九四零零。可以可以可以，不用买。
坐坐坐坐坐坐，
拜拜。
没准备咯。乖乖听话。
他们上面是什么？
会告诉教会的，会告诉教会。
我怕教会的。
Different are you from the character?
Well, in real life, I'm going to talk to you.
Ah, talk to you, talk to you.
Oh, talk to you, yeah.
I don't know, I'll ask them to talk to you.
Talk to you, talk to you.
English, we'll talk English, okay? Okay, okay. Talk to you.
Talk to you, talk to you. Talk to you, talk to you.
Talk to you.
我最近生活，我跟戏里面我一样，很喜欢运动啊，
是，
很喜欢去健身房。不过现实生活的我，不像角色的马可这么 这么屌，那很发巧的。那我刚才对什么 OK 呢？我有人来了吗？
真的吗？
啊，有。
真的吗？你们看真的吗？
真的。哎，我跟大家讲，他在戏里只有对老婆巧而已。啊，
是这样，
是不是？
是
这样。所以讲话总是，我就跟他讲，会讲话正经一点。
好，你是老婆哈 ，I mean yes， 你是一个 mature student。
No， I'm an old student。
old student 啊？
五幺六，不要这样讲啊
，mature student 就好了。
Never mind 啦，你怎么还有 age 啊 ？More important， you must be happy， right？ 啊？哎 ，Father's Happy Father's Day 啊 ，by the way， 啊，父亲节快乐，各位爸爸 ，Yeah。
Yeah, you know, we always talking about like active aging.
Yeah.
How do you feel about being an old student, mature student?
I think it's quite interesting to mix around with the young ones, and they give me a lot of inspiration to be young. Like you can go karaoke until morning, you can drink until morning, you can play until morning.
Morning 几点？
几点？等于6 a.m. 了吗？哇！ Then I think that's good, you know. I mean, you, age is only a number. You must have a lot of positive.
哎，等一下，你说你是 student 还是？是卡拉 OK 型
的，没有在戏里我是输的，是吧？可是戏外我们一定要活得更精彩吗？戏里没有办法吗？你说戏里那个梁美女 very fierce 啊 ，actually I don't like her， I find she very fierce， but I always go bien 啊 ，they ask me to act， I must act like her 吗 ？I cannot say act female， right？ If she's a strong character， she's a strong character。If people dislike her， people dislike her， you know I don't care as long as when I do something and you appreciate， and when I cry you cry with me。That's most important. That means the role is alive, and that's what I really enjoy acting.
I mean, you're a veteran actress. Nobody doesn't like you.
Oh,
amazing,
thank you so much.
Amazing stuff.
Thank you. Yeah, thank you. You're so sweet.
Thanks. James is on stage with us as well.
Hello, everybody.
James, you're on stage from your family. That's great by Marcus Chin.
Yeah, that's right.
Share a little bit more about your father-son relationship, especially since it's.
Correct. This is a Father's Day event, but unfortunately in the show, my relationship with my dad in the show is not really very good. Mm. So because whenever I see my dad, I will be very angry because I don't recognize him as my dad in the show. Because when my character was young, he wasn't a really good dad. He would gamble, he would go out and do a lot of illegal stuff, and he got into jail. So I didn't see him as father. So, for what happens in the show later, you guys gotta watch, and then it's gonna be exciting. But I know right now when I come out, I know it's my dad, I'm just not shouting at him. But yeah.
Okay, 华语，现在华语。
Hello， 大家好，我是谢宏辉。我在戏里玩也是，我起床，然后我在戏里跟我的老爸关系不是很好啦，因为他不是一个很好的老爸，然后我希望你们会喜欢这部戏，谢谢。
Thanks very much, James, for being so obliging. Bilingual cast here, okay?
He's like an Amor. But he's a handsome Amor. And you know this guy can sing very well.
Really?
Yeah, man.
Do you have a Father's Day tune for us?
Yes.
Perhaps? Yes.
Yes.
No? Yes. Who wants to hear a Father's Day tune from James?
Father's Day song.
I need to put you on the spot.
那是妈妈，不是爸爸。
被改
啊！青春是有爸爸，有把你孩子像个爸爸。
Present to all of you out there, right from James here. Let's speak to Denise right now. Denise, yeah! Yeah! You have no fans, is it? No fans at all, huh? You're the daughter of Johnny and Suhan. You're spoiled.
You're selfish.
You're lazy, apparently.
Actually, I'm not lazy.
No?
The complete opposite of
lazy. Explain your character.
Yeah, basically, initially, I'm a workaholic. I work all day.online 是个工作狂，所以从天到晚都在工作。Yeah, so that's the thing is because I've been working so hard,
I kind of left my family, you know, I moved out, and then I don't really spend much time with my family anymore. Yeah, so that's what happened in the story. Yeah. So my dad, so when I kind of like, come in contact with trouble, then I'll look for my dad. Mm. Yeah, especially when it comes to pitching.
Yeah, but I'm sure like all dads out there are very, you know,
they always want to protect their kids, their children. You know, whenever they feel like their child is in need, they will help them.
And that's why all your fans are here, right? Give a round of applause! The artists of 50 and Fab! On Channel 8, of course, you know what 50 and Fab is all about, right? Three good friends in their 50s. They prove that life doesn't stop at 50s. Beyond that, of course, the drama is called Generation Gags as well. And I think it's time for that game. Who's ready for a game? With you.
Okay.
And this is what's going to happen, okay? It's called Shave Like Dad. What we're going to do is we're going to bring four dads up here, their kids, and you're going to join one family. You're going to be adopted for today, okay?
Okay.
That's for today.
Okay.
Huh? And then what's going to happen is they'll be set at those four chairs, the four dads. You guys will line up. The first team, the first member of the team, will race up to dad, place a plastic cover over his face, like we're going to start shaving him. Second team member races to dad, covers his face in shaving cream.
Okay.
You know how to. James, you know how to shaving cream. Okay, good luck to your team member for that. The third team member will use a wooden craft stick, okay, and they're going to shave the dad. So we're not going to use real razors here, it's far too dangerous. Just a wooden stick. And then the last team member rushes to remove that plastic cover from the head. First team wins, okay?
Okay.
Are we ready? Let's bring those families up. Big round of applause for the cast of 50 and Fab, as well as our families coming up right now. Be proud of that day out.
Hello.
Where's your facial hair, sir? Where's your facial hair? Old hair. Does it qualify if he doesn't have facial hair? No? You, sir, have a bit of facial hair. Can. But we'll let you come up. Hi, welcome up on stage. Come on, yes. You qualify. Very good. Hi, sir. Okay, come on. All right, first and foremost, of course, you guys have to adopt your families. All right, okay. James, how about you just go to the first family, the second, the pig, and I. All right, I've just got another tricky rule to the game. The celebrities can only be the first or last member of the team. So they put the plastic onto the face or they pull the plastic off the face, okay? All right, so dad, sit down. The celebrities from 50 and Fab will discuss with the family and strategize exactly how to do it. So everybody clear on the rules and what's supposed to happen? The dads look the most confused. They're like, what's going on? Very serious discussions. It's a very important game. Thank you. look at the strategizing going on. How's it going? How's it going? Let me try and eavesdrop. What's going on? All right, Denise is completely demonstrating what's going to happen. She's taking over this family. Let's see how James is doing. James, do you have a strategy?
Just going to do it fastest.
Are you agreeable? How about you? Are you confident you're going to win it? Oh no! James, he has no confidence in you! What happened? Yes. Yes, one. Either the first or the last classic deck on the head. Let's begin. Oh! You okay, three? Then you'll be the first deck class. So, Ping, are you confident or not?
It seems that they understand it now.
Do you think you're going to win with Ping? How about the one hiding behind you?
Yes!
Alright, the challenge is on! Alright, so, I think the way that we're going to do this is the rest of the family, other than the fathers, come down on this side of the stage. You've got to complete it all within 1 minute. You've got the props there. Everybody get your props. You've got a plastic sheet. You've got the shaving foam. You've got the ice cream sticks. Okay, you've got ice cream sticks for the shavers. And you've got your rolls. Oh, there's a lot of stress for Father's Day. I thought this was meant to be celebrated, Father. Okay, so I'm going to repeat the rules one more time, okay? So, what happens is one team member will move forward, put the plastic sheet on, another team member goes back to the father, sprays the shaving cream on, another team member goes up with the ice cream stick, shaves the deck, make sure he's very, very clean before the last member goes back and takes that sheet off. First team member back here wins! I think what happened?
The little girl. She's so great.
You got shaving cream all over you guys. You can see it even saw it. It's on the face, on your hands. These teams led by the dads, headed by the dads, you guys are going to be in for a shaving good time. Are you ready? Yeah, you actually want a real one, right? Not like one of those ice cream stick concerts. What is this? Alright. Okay, are we ready? Okay, each member, after you're done with your task, run there, run back. Before the next member can go, okay?
Walk.
Can only walk, sorry. Safety, hazard. Okay, everybody, the starting line is here. Everybody can move forward a bit. Yes, can only walk. All right. Hey, you look a bit. Don't cheat, please. Alright, are we ready? Are we ready? And
on your marks.
Get set.
Go.
And go. I'm so glad we only use the ice cream stick. This will be a much different stage if we work. Take as many pictures as you want, please. Although it looks like I put it all in your hand now, not your face. Alright, let's get them some tissues to clean up and a big round of applause to all our families and our celebrities as well from 50 and Feb, Duncan Ping, Irene Tan, James Sia, and our winner for today, Denise! They do still have to make their way home at some point. Happy Father's Day, I hope you enjoyed that. A big round of applause to our cast once again. Once they clean up, where are they? So things like completely distracted. Jojo Ping, Eileen Tan, James Sia, and Denise from 50 and Fab on Channel 8. Make sure you catch it. The drama is currently showing Mondays to Fridays at 9 p.m. Big round of applause to our families as well. Thank you so much for letting us do this to you. Alright, we'll be back with the cast of Code of Law. Very, very shortly. Ah, those are their old fans. Then I can speak English again throughout. Thank you. 50 and Fab happens every day, Monday to Friday, 9 p.m. Thank you very much. Yeah, I don't know. This drama has suspense, mysteries, and most importantly, quite possibly, the hottest serial killer on TV. Do we agree?
Yes!
Does anybody know what show this is? The series is, of course, Code of Law, and it's reaching its exciting finale tomorrow on Channel 5 at 10 p.m. I hope you've got that blocked in your schedule. Of course, if you've missed out on the action, you can always catch up on demand on Toggle. So, ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, let's give a loud welcome to the cast of Code of Law. We've got Michelle Wong, Jitin Ram, Kieran Bauer, and Oon Shu. Welcome to stage and welcome to Dad's Day Out. Wonderful crowd here. Just give us a quick introduction to yourselves and your characters.
Hi, I'm Kieran, and I'm the Stephanie Sito, a lawyer on Code of Law.
Hi, I'm Jitin Ram, and I play Inspector Sanders on Code of Law.
Hi, I'm Michelle Wong, and I play SSGTV, Xiao La Jiao on Code of Law.
And this fella, he doesn't have a mouth to speak.
A very nice Singaporean boy.
Well, okay, we've got a few questions for you, but these are the easy ones before we get to the tough ones. What's the most memorable part of filming this season?
Huh? I think it'll be being reunited with everyone who's been there for like the past three seasons, and even before that with the people. I think it's very nice. It's like the family reunion.
Yeah.
Will you?
I think we had a lot of memorable scenes. One of it is when Michelle made a mistake on set.
Ooh, yeah. Tell all.
So it was a scene where we were all arguing. So it's like myself, Sunny, Michelle, and Sharon. So we are just arguing, all of us just bombarding at each other at the same time. And then Nikki, Michelle's line was, I'm sorry, man, it's my fault. So when we started to shout and all that, then Sharon tells us, like, keep quiet. Michelle goes on to say, I'm sorry, mom, it's my fault. She celebrated Mother's Day quite early.
Sorry, mom.
Michelle, anything to tell on Jitten Room?
Oh, so many things. I request a new addition to the class this season, and it's been really, really fun with the relationship. And everybody's been so chill and so kind, and it's just like,
Interesting. What do you think that dynamic between two characters is like?
I think we would have a lot of fun together.
So, cheeky question. Who do you think would end up like Derek? Who's most likely to end up like Derek, do you think, from the cast?
I think it could happen to anyone.
Oh.
The most unexpected person might end up like Derek.
Alright, why should people get Code of Law, especially tomorrow?
It's the last episode!
I think we're very, very thankful because we just received good news just now that Code of Law was doing quite well. And so we're very, very glad to be part of this production, and we hope that everybody will support us tomorrow to see the conclusion, see what happens to Shu on it, see what happens to
my
favorite.
I think every character has some sort of coming to us.
Just chasing me off. That's my awesome moment. Alright, they want us to start the games. We need three volunteers because you're going to be on the team of our cast of Code of Law. You're each going to be on one of their teams. Oh, I'm experiencing this terribly. But anyway, we need three volunteers. We want dad, especially since you know it is Father's Day, because you stand a chance to win really nice prizes. I think I saw a hand in the back there.
Hey!
Yeah! Guy in the red! Come up here. Yes, you can bring your daughter as well. And the guy in the blue? Yes! A father as well. Let's have him come up. And that guy in the red. Come on up. Alright, brave souls. We're going to be testing your legal knowledge. Your legal knowledge as well. Fantastic. Alright, let's assign you your adopted families. Save your family just now. Alright, so in the blue, maybe you can join Michelle here. Michelle will be on your team. And maybe you can join... Awesome. Okay, so this is the game. And this is the game. Everybody stand to the left and you win. This is what my stage manager tells me. Okay, everybody stand to the left because they want a better picture of you. Alright, the game is easy. I'm going to be reading out some outrageous laws, okay? You have to tell me with your partner, you have to discuss it out. We will be listening in if you're actually discussing it. Decide if what I've read out is actually true or not, okay? Now, I know you might be wondering why I have Desmond standing next to me. Once you have actually decided on the final answer, one of you from each team has to run over, put your face to beat him, and that person gets to answer first. Okay? If you're wrong, then it's the next person who gets to run up as fast as possible. Okay, are you ready? Alright. So I think the kids are able to run as well, but are you going to be tall enough to put your face in there? Okay. Alright, so get ready to discuss. The first law, is it illegal to hold a salmon, like a fish, a salmon, suspiciously in the UK?
I think it's yes.
And you are right! It is true! The Salmon Act of 1986 states so! Well done. Okay. Don't worry, a few more questions to go. Law number two. Is it illegal to name your baby something weird in China?
Yes. The city of Petrolia in Ontario has a law that states no yelling, shouting, whistling or singing is allowed at any time. Well done, well done. Did somebody keep your count up? Law number four. Is it illegal to play an instrument horribly in public in Singapore? Very nervous there. And it's actually true! Yes, you can report your neighbors to the police. They can get a fine of up to $1,000. Law number five. It is illegal to have your chickens cross the road in Georgia. Owners to have their chickens under control at all times. I think Team Blue won, right? The Team Blue, yes! Well done, Team Blue! Fantastic! We've got prizes for you guys! Awesome! Congratulations, you guys did awesome as well. Good running. Nobody really thought through the answers. Now, Code of Law will be reaching its exciting finale tomorrow on Channel 5 at 10 p.m. Of course, if you would like to see more of the beautiful people that you have here on stage, the entire Code of Law series is available on demand at toggle.sg/Code of Law. Thank you very much to our fathers who came on stage, as well as our celebrities, Michelle, Jitendrum, and Shuan. Big round of applause. Thank you very much. Awesome stuff. You guys should come take pictures here as well. The stage will be open for you to get your photo op as Derek. All right, by the way, do you know that all Mediacorp play? So it's enhancing quality of life and contributing to a healthier future. Thank you for joining us today at Singapore Sports Hub for celebrating Father's Dad's Day out. We hope you have enjoyed yourselves and we look forward to a great celebration next year as well. I'm Daphne Lim from 93.8 Now and I'm signing out. Have a very good evening.
Come on. Thank you.